Hey there, everybody. Will Jonathan from Channel Fireball here. And for those of you who may not know who I am, I do sports psychology and mental coaching for a living. I work with professional athletes all the way down to youth athletes, and I've worked with sports teams and sports organizations all over the world. I'm also a huge Magic fan. I play competitive Magic, and I also work with Magic players. And at Channel Fireball, my role is to help you, the competitive Magic player, understand the importance of the mental side of the game, to really grasp and embrace the importance of the psychological side of being a competitive Magic player and why it's so important. Because the fact of the matter is, at the end of the day, you can have all the talent in the world, all of the skill, all of the ability, you can prepare, prep, and research as much as you want. If your mind is not in the right place when you go to perform, none of those things are going to count for anything. Because the fact of the matter is, your mind and your psychology is what's responsible for executing and using those things to their fullest. Okay, and we know this is true. We see this all the time. We all know Magic players personally, or we've seen them at tournaments, right? Prominent players who, you know, very talented, very skilled. They do all the preparation and everything to get ready to compete, but they tilt very easily. They can't control their thoughts and emotions, right? So they throw away games because of that. Or they can't handle losing. When they lose a game or they lose a match, it throws them completely off and they throw away tournaments because of that, right? Or they can't react the right way to winning either, right? They start getting on a little bit of a winning streak, they can't react to it the right way, and they throw away a tournament at the wrong, most crucial moment, right? So we see evidence of this all the time, and the mind is really the difference maker at the end of the day, okay? And like I said, of course, nobody would ever say that talent and skill and ability and preparation aren't important. They definitely are. You have to have those things as a player. But if you don't understand the psychological side of things, and if you don't utilize the mind to its fullest when you go to play, you are limiting your potential and your ability to get the results that you want. Because at the end of the day, your mind is directly responsible for not only the level of your performance, but ultimately it's directly responsible for the results that you produce. And that might sound like a bit of a lofty claim, right? But I'll show you how it works so you can see it, right? So I'll give you a little bit of a visual thing here, okay? So as a competitive Magic player, right, when you go to play in a competitive Magic tournament, all competitive Magic players want the same thing, right? You're after a result, okay? You wanna win, you wanna get great results. This is true from a small scale all the way to a large scale, right? When you sit down to play game one of round one, you want to win that game, right? You want to win game two. You want to win round one, round two, round three. You want to go and you want to win the tournament, you know? Or maybe you just want to finish in the top eight or top 16 or finish in the money or make day two, whatever it is. Ultimately, as a competitive Magic player, you're after a result, okay? Now, what we need to do from here is to work backwards, right? So what is it that produces results? Results only come from one thing and one thing only. If you want to get the results that you want, you have to perform. It's as simple as that, okay? Great performances produce great results. Bad performances produce bad results. Now, as we know, variance is really important in Magic. It has a huge amount of weight, and there are times when you can perform really well and still lose. Okay, but that's not the difference maker. Variance is not what makes the difference at the end of the day, right? We see players, and we all know players, you know, great players in the game who have good win rates consistently, you know? And it's so variance plays a part, but it's not the difference maker, right? At the end of the day, consistently over time, the better you perform, the better results you'll get, and the worse you perform, the worse your results are going to be, okay? So if you want to get a result, you have to perform, okay? Now, what is it that you need in order to perform as well as you possibly can? Okay, what is it that allows you to go to a high-level competitive Magic tournament and do well? Okay, and that is what we talked about before, and that is your ability, right? To play high-level competitive Magic, there's no question, you have to have ability. You have to have skill. You have to have a bit of talent. You have to prepare. You have to research. You have to know the rules of the game. You have to know the interactions of the cards. You need to know the metagame, the best decks in the format. You need to know how your deck that you're going to play interacts with the other decks they're going to be at the tournament, right? So you have to have technical skill, technical ability, and technical knowledge, right? There's no question about that. Now, here's the thing about ability, and this is why ability is not the difference maker at the end of the day. We talked about early in the video. The thing about ability, and I'll ask you this, right? When you go to play in a tournament, when you go to play a single game of Magic, does your full ability, right, your full talent, your full skill, does your full technical ability automatically get used to its fullest every single time you go to play? Yes or no? Well, the answer is obviously no, right? Because if that were true, what would happen? You would never play badly, right? You would always play almost perfectly. You would play at your maximum ability, right? And your results would be incredible. Like, you would just have like a 90% win rate or something. But we know that doesn't happen, right? There are days, there are tournaments when you go and you play and you do really badly. You don't do well. And there are days when you go and you have an amazing performance. You have an amazing tournament. You get great results. The reason for that is because it's kind of unfortunate, right? It kind of stinks, but ability does not get used automatically. And this is kind of getting to the crux of what we're talking about here today in this video, okay? The thing about ability, it has to be drawn out. It has to be used. You have to draw it out of yourself and actually apply it and use it in your games. Now, the question is, what is it that allows you as a competitive Magic player to tap into your full ability, to perform as well as you can, and get the result that you want? What is it that's responsible for bringing out your technical ability? And the answer is your mindset. Okay? This right here is the key. Okay? And when we talk about mindset, we're talking about the state of your thoughts and emotions at any given moment when you're playing. Okay? When you go to play an individual game, or when you go to play over the course of a tournament, your mindset is going to be the difference maker. Why? Because your mindset determines how much of your ability you tap into and draw out and use. That determines what your performance level is like. And then that determines what kind of result that you get. Okay? So let's do an example, right? We'll do two examples, both extremes, right? So let's say you're going into a tournament. You have a tournament coming up. And you've done all the preparation that you needed to do. You've done everything right. You've researched the metagame. You've got a great deck. You know your deck inside and out. You're a great player on a technical level, right? And you show up at that tournament, but for whatever reason, your mindset is in a really bad place. You know, confidence levels are low. Maybe your drive and your desire is not really there. Your motivation to play is not really there. Your passion and enthusiasm levels aren't very high, and your focus and concentration is just all over the place, right? It's not where it needs to be. Because your mindset is in such a bad place, right? How much of your ability are you going to tap into and draw out and use at that tournament? Probably very little, if any, at all, right? And so because you don't tap into and draw out your ability, what's your performance level going to be like? Very bad, or nowhere near what you're capable of. And because your performance level isn't very good, what kind of result do you get? You get a bad result, right? You lose the first match. And because you lose the first match, what does that bad result do to your mindset? Makes it weaker. Confidence levels go down. The desire and motivation to play, that can decrease a bit, right? You start to kind of think, well, what's the point? I've just lost. You know, it's over now. So your desire and motivation to play takes a little bit of a hit. Your enthusiasm, you know, your energy levels maybe decrease a little bit, and your focus and concentration can go out the window because you're thinking about this match that you just lost instead of, you know, the one that's coming up. So your mindset gets even weaker. So what happens next round? You tap into even less of your ability. You play even worse. And what happens? You get another bad result. You're 0-2, right? And what does that bad result do to your mindset again? It makes it even weaker. Right? You start tapping into even less of your ability. You perform even worse. You get an even worse result. And next thing you know, you're on this downward cycle, and it's poisonous and it's self-fulfilling. And if this looks familiar, this is what a losing streak looks like. And this is where losing streaks come from. This is how they happen. You get a bad result. You don't react to it mentally in the correct way. And that affects how much of your talent and your skill and your ability that you draw and you use in your next game, in your next round, in your next tournament, right? You didn't forget how to play Magic. You didn't become a bad Magic player. You didn't react to your bad result in the right way, and you allowed it to affect your mindset, which prevented you from tapping into and using your full ability and potential as a player, which means your performance levels aren't good, which continues the bad results, and those bad results just make your mindset weaker, and this is how you end up on losing streaks. Okay? That makes sense, right? Now, let's look at the opposite of that, right? The good side. It's not all doom and gloom, you know? Same thing. You have a tournament coming up. You go into the tournament, and you've done everything. You're prepared. You're researched. You're ready. You know your deck. You know the metagame. You're ready to go. And when you walk into that tournament hall, your mindset is in a peak state. Confidence levels are high. You have a lot of self-belief. Your desire and motivation to compete and do well is in a really good level. You're passionate, you're enthusiastic, you're energized to play, and your focus and concentration levels are like a laser. They're exactly where they need to be, right? When you go to play that first round, that first game, how much of your ability, you know, and your talent and your skill are you going to draw out when your mindset's in that kind of state? A lot, right? You're going to tap into and draw out your full ability. As a consequence of that, what's your performance level going to be like? Really good or at its maximum. And because you perform really well and maximize your performance, what kind of result do you get? You get a really good result. You win the first round, right? And because you win the first round, what does that do to your mindset? It gets even stronger. Confidence levels goes up. You know, I can do this. Like, yeah, like I'm a good player. I just beat a great player. Like I can go and do this, right? Your desire and your motivation to keep playing increases, right? Your passion levels, your enthusiasm, your energy gets a bit stronger. Your focus and concentration gets a bit stronger, right? So your mindset gets stronger. Going into round two, you tap into even more of your ability. You perform even better. You get an even better result. That result strengthens your mindset, right? All of a sudden, you're on an upward cycle, and that upward cycle is what a winning streak looks like. Okay, you get a great result, mindset gets even stronger, you tap into your ability, you put in a great performance, you get another great result. And this is how players go 2-0, 3-0, 4-0, 5-0 in a tournament. It's also how they get consistently great results at tournaments back to back to back to back to back because their mindset's in the right place. So as you can see, and as we've demonstrated here in both extremes, when it comes to losing and when it comes to winning, good results and bad results, it all has its roots here in your mindset, in your mentality, right? In your attitude and in your psychology. This is the key to everything, right? If you want to get great results as a player, you have to perform. You have to put in good performances. The only way to put in good performances is you have to draw out and use your ability, your technical ability. Research the game, prepare for tournaments, do play testing, build up and develop your technical skill and your ability, but understand that that is not going to get used automatically when you sit down and play in tournaments. You have to draw that out and you have to use it, okay? And the way you do that is with making sure your mind, your mindset is in a peak state and it's where it needs to be, okay? So as you can see, that's why the mind is so important, and it has a direct impact on your ability to perform and get the results that you want. And that's why you need to care about the mental side of the game. And if you don't, you need to start exploring this side of the game and of yourself a little bit so that you can start performing like you're capable of and getting the results that you want. Okay. So listen, I appreciate you coming out and watching this video. I encourage you to stay tuned because in part two, that's going to be coming out later this week, we're going to talk about mindset, okay? Because it's well and good to know that mindset is important and it's the key to getting the result that you want in Tournament Magic, right? But you may be wondering, well, that's all good, but how do I get myself into a peak state so that I can perform my best? And how do I keep myself in a peak state mentally during the tournament so that I can get the results that I want? So stay tuned for the next video. Part two is going to come later in the week. And in that video, we're going to talk about how to create mindset and how to sustain it over the course of a tournament so that you can get great results. Okay. So thanks again for coming out. And I will see you again very soon. Thanks.